The Education Resources Information Center, or ERIC, is an online library of education research that is part of the Institute of Education Sciences in the U.S. Department of Education. ERIC released a new application programming interface, or API, that many researchers have found to be helpful. An API is a way of exporting data electronically. It is typically used to feed data into apps and websites. It is designed for machine-to-machine communications. ERIC launched the API to help share our almost 2 million records with developers and researchers who want to integrate ERIC data with their tools. This video demonstrates how you can use the API when conducting a systematic literature review. One benefit of the API is that it allows you to export work to a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet so you can take notes, identify relevant work, and keep track of articles screened out as irrelevant. This significantly eases the burden of a literature review. Let's start our API demo by conducting a brief literature review in ERIC. Imagine you are working on a paper about teaching English learners with autism and you are identifying search terms. First, we'll go to the ERIC homepage at eric.ed.gov. Note that there is no www to start the URL. Then, decide on your search terms. We recommend starting with the ERIC Thesaurus. The ERIC Thesaurus is a controlled vocabulary, or a set of terms used to tag ERIC records. When you search the thesaurus for English learners, you see the preferred term is English language learners. This is an older term, but it is used as the descriptor because ERIC assigns terms based on literary warrant, or the language used in the published literature. Terms in the published literature tend to lag from terms used in the field. Since English language learners is the ERIC descriptor, we will use it in our search. It will retrieve relevant records regardless of the terminology in the content. When we search for our second term, autism, we see that it exactly matches the ERIC descriptor. Now, we will perform our search. There are two ways to do this. In the first example, we'll simply search for English language learners, in quotes because it is a phrase, and autism. This search returns 33 results. For the second example, let's click on Advanced Search Tips. A better way to search is by using field-specific search on descriptors from the thesaurus, and this page shows you how. Using a descriptor field search narrows the results to only the records tagged with those terms in the descriptor field. The other method of using descriptors without specifying the field searches multiple fields and returns more results, likely from the terms appearing in the abstract. This search returned 22 results, so by using a field search, you get fewer, more relevant results. Now we are ready to export our results to a file. We will rerun the search in the API and export the results to an Excel spreadsheet so there is no need for copying and pasting. To do this, go to the ERIC webpage footer and select API. Once in the API, scroll down and select Get. Selecting Get brings up the list of API parameters. First on the list is Search, and it provides guidance for searching with the API. We will come back to this parameter later. For now, let's scroll down and look at Fields. Note that some field names differ between the ERIC search feature and the API. The Fields parameter displays the field names used in both. We know we want to run a descriptor search, and the table shows that the ERIC term descriptor is called subject in the API. We'll start our search by scrolling to the top and selecting Try It Out. In the search box, enter subject English language learners and subject autism. We are including the AND operator here because the default between terms is OR. You must insert AND to get records containing both autism and English language learners. Next, put CSV in the format box so the results open easily in an Excel file. CSV, or comma-separated values, is easily used by Excel and other spreadsheet tools. Then, scroll down to the rows box to select the number of expected results. By default, the API will return 20 results with a maximum of 2,000. We are going to enter 200 here since we know there could be more than 20, but fewer than 200. Now, scroll down and click Execute. Then, download the file and drag the file to your desktop. Now, go to Excel and go to Open. Go to On My Mac or Browse if you are on a PC to find the file. Select the file and click Open. In the Text Import wizard, select Delimited and then click Next. Then, uncheck Tab and check Comma. Select Finish. Now, here are our results in an Excel spreadsheet. If you have additional files, you can download and merge them. Now you have a nice set of search results in an Excel file. How are you going to use it? You will likely need to merge results of several searches with slightly different terms to get a more comprehensive view of the literature. Then you can remove duplicates based on ERIC ID, which is the unique identifier. After that, you will likely go through each record systematically to see if the article is relevant. The ERIC API is a powerful tool that can be used to help education researchers with their work. It also provides an easy mechanism for loading ERIC metadata to third-party systems. For more information about the ERIC API, please contact us through the help desk at ericrequests@ed.gov. For more resources related to this topic, check out the following.